Don, Sotheby's recently releasing its fall forecast, suggesting that in the first half of 2021, it has been an unprecedented year when it came to luxury real estate in Canada. We're well into the fall now. Give us an idea of what market conditions look like when it comes to luxury real estate.
Well, it's definitely been quite a year. As you said, we've kind of had a frenzied start to the year. Then we went into a bit of a summer slowdown in the summer, and every market was tended to be a little bit different. But coming into the fall, where it's quite interesting what's happening, because we're starting to see a return to living back in the city as being an acceptable mode of living. So we're starting to see more people coming back to the city with all the restrictions that have, been put in place. So we're starting to see the cities come back alive. Now, this doesn't mean that we've seen a lack of interest in the rural and the suburban properties. I think there's been a permanent shift, or at least a temporary shift in the mindset of buyers. So there's a lot of people that are still going to have the residual effects of the pandemic, and they'll still look outside the city, but we're starting to see more people come back to the city. And as a result of that, we have this chronic undersupply of inventory right now as people come back to the city. And what that's doing is putting more kind of interest on the condominium space. And this is pretty much happening right across the country. It's happening in Toronto, it's happening in Montreal, it's happening in Calgary, and it's happening in Vancouver. So there's this renewed interest in the condo market as well too. And we're also seeing that the luxury markets are flourishing as a result as well. So this is happening all across the country. And, we are seeing different nuances in each market across the country. And we're coming in, we're obviously at the end of, we just finished September. September has been a very robust month for us. I think there were a number of people that in different areas held back in terms of coming into the fall market because of the election, because there was also a lot of buyer fatigue from all the frenzied activity before. So we're starting to see the markets pick up and all across the country at this point in time.
Don, I heard you mention the word supply. What do you think is driving sales in the luxury market? And do you see it moving in tandem with the conventional market? Because supply, obviously, one of the big issues in the mainstream market as well.
Yeah, we're starting to see probably a bigger gap that's happening in the luxury versus the conventional market. I think there's, as a result of the pandemic, we talked about this last time, how there's been a lot of accumulation of cash and a lot of savings that have been amassed over time. And so then there's a certain segment of the population that is looking to either invest in a bigger home, or they've upgraded their home. And we've seen a lot of homes actually through renovations actually increase in value and move up the price spectrum. So we are seeing this gap between conventional and luxury that is happening right now in the market. And it's happening all across the country as well.
And how long do you see this momentum lasting? Do you see headed into 2022? Ottawa has suggested a tax on vacant properties. Will this contribute to some kind of a slowdown?
Well, I think the underlying issue hasn't changed. We have a chronic undersupply of housing inventory in Canada. We've had it for decades. We continue to have it. I think case in point, if you take the Golden Horseshoe, our labs just came out with a report that said that based on immigration, the way things are trending, we should have 154,000 homes pretty much brought in every year to handle the demand. I think right now we're averaging 65,000 homes in the Golden Horseshoe. The average supply that's being created is 42,000. So we have an ongoing deficit of 23,000 homes each year. And so this is happening right now. And, the government has talked about bringing 1.6 million new, Canadian permanent residents into the Canada over the next number of years. So when you take into our deficit, you take into our the future needs, You know, we're going to be in this situation for quite some time. So I see this trend continuing, you know, well into 2022 and potentially beyond.
The report focuses on properties over that $1 million mark, the $4 million mark, and the $10 million mark. When you take a look at cities across the country, Toronto, Vancouver, Montreal, Calgary, what can you tell us about luxury home sales?
Well, if you take the Toronto market right now, like we had a bit of a dip, a very small dip in the summer market, and we've come into a very strong fall market. There, once again, there's a severe shortage of inventory. So we're going to see price acceleration. There's a shortage of detached homes. It's pushing people to the condos as well, too. So, you know, I think we are going to see probably a very strong fall market in the Toronto area and the GTA area. And like I said, you know, we're seeing very strong sales in the luxury condo space as well, too. So this is it's a fairly common occurrence that's happening in each major center. There are nuances, but right now I would say, you know, Toronto is probably the hottest market in the Canadian market space right now.
Tell us about what's happening in Vancouver.
Okay, so Vancouver is, you know, they did have a bit of a slowdown in the summer. And one of the things that, you know, they are plagued with is they definitely have a severe shortage in different price ranges. And because there has been some price escalation, some homes have moved along the spectrum and moved up. We do see there's a fair bit of inventory in the ultra luxury space. But in the luxury level in the conventional market, there's still a lot of activity that's going on. So that is, you know, once again, all demand that is really being locally driven at this point. Now, this doesn't mean that we're not having interest from international buyers. They just haven't been able to come back to the market. So all of this demand, you know, in Vancouver right now is really locally driven. So this will intensify once things open up, you know, and the international buyers start coming back.
You've mentioned a few times this notion of returning to the city and that we've seen an uptick in luxury condos. What are some of the shifts that you've been seeing when it comes to housing?
Well, I think, you know, one of the things we're seeing is that during the pandemic, a lot of people, they couldn't necessarily find the home that they wanted to find. So then they started looking at different amenities. So they started, you know, adding luxury amenities. These could be, you know, new technology, home automation. They might have put in spas into their home. They might have put wine cellars. So they've been adding a lot of these amenities that obviously increase the value of the home. And they did this because they couldn't find a satisfactory residence to go to. So prior to the pandemic, the luxury buyer tended to want to buy in something that was already, you know, everything was done. It was like move-in condition. And so the pandemic's, you know, basically because of the inventory levels, they had to say, well, we can't find what we want. So now we're going to build what we want. So that's one of the probably prevailing trends that has, you know, resulted from the pandemic and continues to this day.
Don, we've seen these soaring valuations in both the mainstream market and the luxury market. Has that price threshold changed for traditional luxury?
I think there's definitely been some movement upwards. I think, you know, the average prices are creeping up and the definition of luxury, you know, tends to be moving a little farther along the spectrum. So we are definitely seeing some movement in what defines a luxury versus, you know, a conventional type market.
Tell us about properties in Canada in that $20 million mark.
I mean, they don't exactly move as quick as other properties. Obviously, they're very discerning value, you know, buyers that are looking for this property. One thing that we are seeing a trend that is coming forward in the ultra luxury space is a lot of the buyers and even a lot of the sellers don't necessarily want to put their properties on MLS. There's now this new concern about privacy. They don't want their name out there. They don't want, you know, prices published. And so now we're starting to see the ultra luxury buyer and seller finding, you know, companies that have private client lists or international marketing that is discreet and just targets a certain class. So that's something that's relatively new that we've never seen before. And it's a trend that's happening both in Vancouver and in Toronto as well. Not a large scale, but we're starting to see this happen.